Mais comme les tempêtes, moi, je voulais les porter. Mais il y a un rapport.
Established on 4th January 1987, Entebbe Namate Archdeaconry has now earmarked 35 years of existence while spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. The theme of celebrations comforts believers not to lose. The theme of celebration comforts believers not to lose hope, but rather be strong when faced with challenges. The Bishop of Namidembe, Emeritus Right Reverend Samuel Balagade Sekade, was the main celebrant representing Right Wilberforce Chitiolu Walida, the Bishop of Namidembe Diocese. The guest preacher, Right Reverend Felix Odey Anansi from Ghana, encouraged believers to reflect on the past. He also encouraged the youth to be courageous amid challenges, and he further challenged Christians to take care of the elderly.
To him, all the possibilities, he has hoping to this archdeaconry during this past 35 years. The theme for this anniversary, be strong and of good courage.
Reverend Canon John Jita Kavuma of Entebbe Archdeacon highlighted the church's commitment to work with government in addressing challenges that are hindering service delivery in the country.
Quantities for renovation works are available for your review and consideration. And your reminder about our request for official archdeaconry vehicle.
In his message, read by the Vice President Jessica Alupo, President Museveni commended the church for its role in eradicating poverty. The president asked political and cultural leaders to encourage Christians to embrace all government programs aimed at eradicating unemployment and poverty.
The most obvious tasks of the church is the spiritual well-being of the people. The church has also championed development-related projects focused at enhancing the physical well-being of the communities in such areas as health, education, tourism, etc. While working for God's coming kingdom, we should not neglect our lives here on earth.
The church lauded the president for championing the Emyoga and Parish Development Model Initiative, which are aimed at eradicating poverty among Ugandans. The church also noted that it has introduced a saving culture among its members. However, they say they need more funding.
Church completion of the wall fence and paving even the ground, which is estimated at 400 million only. We therefore request you, Your Excellency, to stand with us, since we are the only archdeaconry hosting, Your Excellency.
Land grabbing has been pointed out as one of the challenges faced by the church, and President Yoweri Museveni has been reminded about his pledge of the archdeaconry vehicle to ease smooth operation of the church work.
Your Excellency, as earlier on requested during my inauguration, a delegation from State House advised me that the archdeacon's official car would not be considered during the previous budget. But they promised me that during this financial year 2022-23, the State House will spearhead the archdeacon's vehicle.
The vice president responded to some of the comments raised by area leaders and gave assurance that some of these issues will be addressed immediately.
The NRA manifesto is in the National Development Plan, and government does face the implementation of those infrastructure projects. Very certain that keeping the road will be worked on, because as you have already said, Entebbe Archdeaconry is the face or the image of the church.
The Archdeaconry head office seeks 1.5 billion shillings to finish construction of the church. Today, the president contributed 60 million towards the cause. Entebbe Archdeaconry has over 163 churches covering parts of Wakiso, Kampala, and Kalangala. Report compiled by Godfrey Sempija for the news.